Hi everyone, welcome to Wave Hill. My name is Brian Bradley and I'm a Falconer from upstate New York, and I come down to Wave Hill at an annual event called Wings Over Wave Hill and do a presentation, and we decided that we would do a little bit of a video presentation for you today using some of the birds that I have during my program. So something you can enjoy during COVID time, so to speak. Our first bird is a screech owl, which is one of our smallest species of owl here in North America. He's a tiny little bird, and people often think that because he's so small, he's a baby and he's naturally going to grow larger, but he's actually a full-grown owl. He's just a smaller species of owl. There's a wide range of size in all birds of prey because they're required by nature to catch a wide range of prey out there. So a small bird like this is going to catch small prey like insects, small birds. The main prey, however, are going to be small rodents like mice that they catch on the ground. We all know, of course, that owls are nocturnal. And another assumption that people will often make is that on a bright sunny day like today, the birds are uncomfortable in the sun, or it hurts their eyes, or they have to sleep all day and can only come out at night. But actually, none of that is true. All the owls are perfectly able to function both day and night. They just have some special skills and abilities to do their hunting and are by far more active at night. There are both gray and red phase screech owls in North America. This is a red phase. Camouflage is important. For his survival, being a small bird, he's vulnerable to other larger birds of prey. So his ability to blend in, not only to the colors of his environment, tree that he might be sitting in, but also to hide in a hole in a tree, helps to protect him when he's not out there flying around and hunting at night in his own element. They nest in a hole in a tree, and they'll also hide in a hole in a tree during the day. And it's called a screech owl. However, they actually don't make a screeching sound at all. They make a beautiful flute-like whistling noise. They all have a vocabulary and are capable of making different sounds. Okay, so our little screech owl, one of the things you might notice about him is that he has these little tufts of feathers sticking up on top of his head. That's another aspect of his camouflage. Some of the forest-dwelling owls have what we call horns. They're called horns, of course, but they're not really horns. They're just feathers. And the bird, he can actually manipulate those feathers. He can lay them down flat on his head and make them disappear, or stick them straight up. Now, let's say, for example, if he was out during the day on a bright sunny day like today, he might be sitting up against the trunk of a tree. Close those brightly colored eyes and stick those two tufts of feathers up. It breaks up his outline. It changes his shape. It makes him look like something he's not. Basically, they represent small twigs or sticks so that he looks like a part of the tree. In shape and blending in color helps him to disappear from sight. And normally, as a falconer or bird handler in general, I'd be wearing a leather glove when handling birds of prey because obviously they have powerful feet and sharp claws. But in the case of this little bird, I don't really need the gloves. So I hold on to the leather straps. All the birds wear soft leather straps called jesses that are attached to around the bird's ankles. And that allows me to control the bird when I'm handling him on the fist or the glove. But being that he's so small, I have a better feel of the bird on my hand when I'm using my bare hand. So thank you for joining us at Wave Hill today. It's a beautiful day, and we hope to be able to see you again here in the future. Please support Wave Hill and come to any other programs. We're going to put our little screech owl away, and you'll be able to meet another bird another day.